Hey, it's Coach M here. Does your teen have low self-confidence or low self-esteem? Do they shy away from taking healthy risks, constantly telling themselves and others how they're not good enough, not attractive enough, not smart enough? Do you hear them saying things like, I'm so stupid, why can't I do anything right? And you feel like you've tried everything possible to help them feel better about themselves? If so, this video is definitely for you. I've got two of the best tools for you to help your teen improve their self-confidence, coming up. Before I give you these amazing tools to help your teen increase their self-confidence, please hit that subscribe button for me. I'm on a mission to help as many parents and teens as possible to start creating the life they desire, deepening their relationship with themselves and others, and truly taking their life to the next level. And as you know, every subscribe button pushed helps YouTube's algorithm get this content out in front of so many more parents and teens. Thank you. If your teenager is burying their head and hiding from their life, feeling like they just don't want to do anything outside of their comfort zone, it's because they have the belief that they're not good enough as they are, which stems from not feeling understood and accepted. Whether we want to believe it or not, oftentimes this feeling they have is coming from us parents. More than likely, your teenager feels like they have to be what you expect them to be in order to feel loved and accepted. There's a part of us that doesn't want to believe this as parents. We think, of course we love our children unconditionally. And although we do overall, we have to challenge ourselves a little with this idea. Because let's face it, we're not loving them unconditionally when we're angry with them, when we yell at them, when we constantly tell them how to act, what they should look like, and who we want them to be. When we do this, all they see and hear from us is that they're not good enough as they are. Now, you may want to resist this idea, but I'm going to ask you to take a closer look and really lean in here to what loving unconditionally really looks like. It's not steeped in negative feelings towards someone. It's not expecting them to be a certain way to make us feel better or to make us look like a good parent. It's about fully loving them in all their imperfection, all their messiness. It's about seeing them as a true, beautiful spirit that they really are, that is far greater than anything they could ever do, they could ever say, they could ever think or believe. Right? Yet, of course, we're human and we forget this. And before you go beating yourself up, you need to know that it's not your fault. You're simply perpetuating a pattern that you weren't even aware of until right now. Of course, now that we know and we see what we're doing and how it's hurting our child, we can make the decision to stop the pattern and to start the healing process with our teen. It begins with our awareness and the willingness to shift our parenting dynamic so that our teen never again feels like we don't love them unconditionally, that they aren't good enough as they are. We have to help our teens see their true self. Okay, Coach M, how in the world do I do that? That's what you're thinking, right? Because you feel like you've tried everything. You've tried encouraging your teen, telling them how great they really are. You may have even tried getting them outside help from a therapist, but you feel like nothing has helped, right? What if I told you that you hold the key to your teen's self-confidence? With a few specific shifts in what you say and do, you could help your teen eliminate their low self-confidence and low self-esteem. How awesome would that be? Well, it's true. And I'm going to give you two of those specific steps right now that you can start doing today. Okay, first step, find and focus on their values. Your teenager has their own set of values that they live by, and they may be very different than yours. Help them identify their top 10 core values. I've got a great core values activity linked in the description down below that you can print out and see if your teen is open and willing to try it with you. It'll actually help you and your teen identify the top core values for each of you. This allows you both to understand each other a little better, and it helps your teen understand themselves more. This leads to more self-confidence. You'll want to make sure to use the ITA method before trying to bring this up with your teen, though. If you don't know what the ITA method is, check out the video here and it's linked in the description down below. The ITA method is crucial to practicing before you engage with your teen, especially if you're asking them to try something new with you. After you and your teen find your core values, talk about them and compare them. Then try to think of times when your teen has acted in alignment with their values and share those memories with your teen. Just make sure that you keep the conversation light and fun for them. You won't want to joke on their expense, but a little self-deprecation on your part can help your teen connect with you more. So saying something like, I noticed one of my core values is courage, but remember how freaked out I got when that spider ran across the floor? I nearly jumped onto the kitchen table. I wasn't so courageous then, was I? This is key. You'll want to make a special point to acknowledge your teen when they are living from their values. So if one of your teen's values is thoughtfulness, and let's say they want to share their video games with their friends, or give a friend their old iPhone case, or do something special for a friend's birthday. First, let them do it, and then say something like, "You really are such a thoughtful friend. I wish I could have had more friends like you growing up." Then walk away. You don't want to go on because it won't come across genuine. Just briefly mention it and then just keep going. When we can do this as parents and really pay attention to when our teen is in alignment with their values, it helps our teen feel so much better about themselves. They begin to recognize how great they feel when they're living in accordance with their values, which builds their self-confidence. Step two, always use the need tool whenever your teen wants to talk to you, especially when they're upset, having a tough time, and really needing someone to talk to. As parents of teens, sometimes we get used to our teen not talking to us very much. They just kind of go off and do their own thing, and we assume everything's okay with them. You want to create a safe space for your teen to come to you when they're struggling. And you want to check in with them often so that you can detect if everything's okay or if they're really needing to talk. Oftentimes our teens don't want to be a bother or a burden to us, especially if they already feel like we don't have much time for them, or if they feel like we really don't care about what's going on with them. So check in with your teen frequently and ask them the question, "How are you feeling?" instead of "How are you doing?" It's a subtle difference in words, but you can get quite a different response sometimes. When your teen does want to talk to you about something, you'll want to use the need tool, which reminds you to ask the question to yourself of, "What does my child need in this moment right now?" The N stands for now, which means be in the present moment, be in the now with your child. Put your phone down, turn away from your computer, face your child, give them your full, undivided attention. The first E in the need tool stands for empathy. Remember, feelings first, always. You're going to empathize with how they feel in the moment, and you always want to do this first. This requires us imagining that we were going through whatever they're going through. How would we feel? What would we think? Then you'll want to say something like this to your teen. "Oh, wow, that must have been really awful. I bet you feel horrible and so disappointed. I can only imagine how sad you probably feel right now." Again, feelings first, always. Remember to validate their feelings before you say anything else. The second E in the need tool stands for empower. After you've empathized with their feelings, you're now going to empower them by asking them the right questions at the right time. If you need help with what empowering questions look like, check out the video here and it's linked in the description below. You'll only want to ask empowering questions when you're talking with your teen. You'll need to desperately fight the urge to fix their problem for them or give them a list of solutions that they could try. Trust me here, don't do it. Fight that urge. This is where the magic happens in helping your teen build self-confidence. It's when they find the answers for themselves, not when an answer is given to them. So again, you're not going to give them advice. You're not going to tell them what you think or how you think they should handle the situation. Take yourself out of the picture and turn the lens back towards your teen and what they think and how they feel. By doing this, you're helping your teen to think about the entirety of the situation. You're helping them to find the best solution for themselves. And again, this is what builds their self-confidence. And last but not least, the D in the need tool stands for draw upon their strengths. After you've asked empowering questions and your teen starts to see what they can do to make a situation better, you'll then want to help your teen see their strengths within the situation. So let's say your teen had a fight with their best friend over a misunderstanding. And after talking with your teen using the need tool, your teen decides to write their friend a text explaining the misunderstanding and apologizing for hurting their friend's feelings. You can say something like this: "I think it's really awesome that you're apologizing to your friend for what you see as your part in the misunderstanding. It shows a lot of courage and thoughtfulness, and it shows how much you value the friendship." Always leave the conversation with your teen by tapping into their strengths. This helps them see themselves better and will grow their self-confidence in a huge way. I have another powerful strategy linked in the description below for helping your teen's confidence after they've made a mistake, which, as you know, one of the leading reasons for low self-confidence is directly related to the mistakes we make, how they're handled, and whether we tie our self-worth to the mistakes or not. Just click on the link in the description below and I'll send you this free powerful strategy. It's a game changer for sure. If you've enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you want to see more videos like it, where I give you the tools to help you navigate the teen years, be sure to hit that subscribe button down below and click on the bell icon to get notified when I upload a new video. And I upload videos every week. Remember, with a few small shifts, you can help eliminate your teen's low self-confidence. I hope your week is amazing, and I'll see you in the next video.